بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء وسيد المرسلين وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين. My dear brothers and sisters, I greet you with the greeting of Al-Islam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Now to start off, we all know as Muslims that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to us the Quran as a roadmap, as a source of guidance for us to be successful in this life and ultimately in the hereafter. It is, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes, a tibyanan li kulli shay, that it is a clarification for everything we need to know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how to worship Him and how to follow the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. But I want to talk about a topic which will directly impact our relationship with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, we are not robots. We have emotions, we have feelings. And it is very important for us as Muslims to be in touch with our feelings and our emotions and our iman and how we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is what I want to talk about, al-husnu dhannu billah, to have good thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, many of us, we may be aware that our feelings and our emotions have a very big impact on how we worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine that optimistic servant who is constantly thinking good about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and expecting the very best, how that will push them to worship Allah jalla wa ala even more. As opposed to a person maybe is quite negative, who's quite pessimistic, and that causes them to be lazy, to lose hope, and then fall into sin and far away from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us in the Quran to think about His signs, to think about His names and attributes, to think about the many blessings that He gave to us subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَإِن تَعُدُّ نِعْمَةُ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. If you think about the many blessings that Allah Jalla wa'ala gave to you, you would never be able to enumerate them. They are so many. By thinking in a positive manner, you can increase your effectiveness in your ibadah, in your worship, in your dua, anything that you do for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, contrary to what many Muslims think, we do have control over our own actions. Now, there are times when the shaitan may whisper to us evil thoughts, which may want us to be lazy or to think bad of our own situation. But it is, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says regarding these waswasa, إِنَّ كَيْدَ الشَّيْطَانِ كَانَ ضَعِيفًا, that the plots and plans of shaitan are something very weak. We have ultimate control, بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى, over the decisions that we make, which will be for our betterment in this life, and we will reap the benefits and the fruits in the hereafter. Now, what do we do if these waswasa, if these whispers come to us? First and foremost, you seek refuge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You say, أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ. Secondly, إِسْتَعِن بِاللَّهِ, that you seek Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help, that enables you to move on from this. And immediately, whatever evil thought has come to you, you dismiss that thought, that you do not act upon that bad thought, that you move on and you do something positive. Be optimistic. Make tasbih. Make some tasbih, say subhanallah, say astaghfirullah, say alhamdulillah. Think about something which is good, which will allow you to move on. We don't believe in bad omens. And it is as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, la tiyarata wala. It is as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, la tiyara wa khayruha al-fa'al. That there are no such things as bad omens, but the best of it is optimism. The companions, they said, ya Rasulullah, what is this fa'al? What is this optimism? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, al-kalimatu salihah yasma'uha, that it is a righteous word that people will hear. Whenever you hear about a situation, whenever you hear about a scenario, you think good about it. Never think negatively about that. Have in mind what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has in store for you. For Allah jalla wa ala is the best planner. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who wants to forgive and to guide His servants. So you think the very best of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All of this is linked to positive thinking and optimism and falling in line with the guidance of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Whenever one of you makes a dua, do you ever think, why will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answer my dua? Whenever you call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whenever you make dua, what is your feeling? What are your emotions? Are you doing that sincerely, seeking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's answer, seeking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's ijabah from that particular dua? Or are you just merely lip service saying, oh Allah, give me this, oh Allah, give me that? Maybe it is better for you to make one simple dua, to be sincere, with your mind and your heart and your soul, your entire existence, present when making that dua, as opposed to you repeating something which your heart is not in it at all. You should remember that every dua, every supplication that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asked, that He subhanahu wa ta'ala, He hears that. And that Allah jalla wa ala knows that everything what is in your heart. You remember that there is no leaf that falls from a tree anywhere on this earth except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that. That no fish in the deepest part of the ocean that no one has ever discovered, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has full knowledge about that creation. This should remind us, subhanAllah. We should remember that no leaf falls from any tree on earth except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has knowledge of it. No fish in the deepest part of any ocean or sea on earth except that Allah jalla wa ala has knowledge of that. So whenever you make dua, the thoughts that you have, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has full knowledge of that. You remember that when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يَخْفَى عَلَيْهِ شَيْءٌ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَلَا فِي السَّمَاءِ, that truly nothing is hidden from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the earth or in the heavens. For this reason, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam told us to make dua, to supplicate to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we remember the hadith of Anas ibn Malik radiallahu an, when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam said, إِذَا دَعَى أَحَدَكُمْ فَلْيَعْزِمْ فِي الدُّعَاءِ وَلَا يَقُلْ اللَّهُمَّ إِنْ شِئْتَ فَأَعْطِينِي فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ فَلَا مُسْتَكْرِهَ لَهُ. When any one of you supplicates, then let them be determined in their supplication, and that they should not say, Oh Allah, give to me if you will. For indeed there is no one to coerce or force Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you make dua, you do it as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us, أُدْعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَنْتُمْ مُوقِنُونَ بِالْإِجَابَةِ, that you call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you are certain of a response from Allah jalla wa ala. Now the famous scholar Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani rahimahullah, when commenting on this hadith, he said that the meaning of this determination is to be persistent in the supplication and to affirm what is asked, that it will occur and that it will happen bi-idhnillahi ta'ala. For this reason, every single Muslim should strive to fulfill what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded them with, and that being certain that Allah jalla wa ala will answer their supplication. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as He tells us, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُخْلِفُ الْمِعَادِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never breaks His promise. And the one who is sincere, where their heart is present, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer their supplication. If someone assumes that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not answer their ibadah or not answer their supplication, or that there is actually no benefit in this, then no doubt this is a form of despair. This is a form of despairing from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's mercy and could fall into a major sin. We remember when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us in the Quran, when Ibrahim alayhi salam, he said, قَالَ وَمَنْ يَقْنَتُ مِنْ رَحْمَةِ رَبِّهِ إِلَّا الضَّالُونَ, and those who despair from the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they are the ones who have been led astray. Now, were a person to die in such a state, having these false assumptions about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what would happen to them? Perhaps maybe they would get what they expected from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We remember the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, when we make dua, to remember how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers the supplications of His servants. In the hadith of Abu Sa'id al-Khudri radiallahu anhu, and this is an amazing hadith, brothers and sisters, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَا مِن مُسْلِمٍ يَدْعُو بِدَعْوَةٍ, that there is no Muslim who calls upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, لَيْسَ فِيهَا إِثْمٌ وَلَا قَطِيئَةُ الرَّحِمِ إِلَّا أَعْطَاهُ اللَّهُ بِهَا إِحْدَى ثَلَاثٍ, that supplication that you are making, it does not contain any sin, it does not contain that you will break any relation or link with any family member, except that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you one of three. Number one, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer the dua of the one who is invoking Him and calling upon Him. Or secondly, وَإِمَّا أَن يَدَّخِرُهَا لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will save that supplication for them in the hereafter. Or thirdly, وَإِمَّا أَن يَصْرِفُ عَنْهُم مِّنَ السُّوءِ مِثْلَهَا, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will divert any harm that may come to that person by that what they are asking. When the companions radiallahu anhum, when they heard this, they said, Ya Rasulullah, إِذَن سَنُكْثِرْ, that we will do lots and lots of dua. We will ask many times from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala if this is going to be the outcome. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam responded, Allahu Akbar, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has even more than you could imagine from that what you are asking. This is the teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And whenever we make dua, this is why we should be optimistic. And this is why we should have good thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in the hadith in Qudsi, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, إِنْ ظَنَّ بِي خَيْرًا فَلَهُ وَإِنْ ظَنَّ شَرًّا فَلَهُ, that if he thinks good of me, that person, they will have it. And if he thinks evil of me, then they will have it. This hadith is hadith sahih in the Musnad of Imam Ahmad. Abu Huraira radiallahu an mentions to us a very beautiful hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, إِنْ حُسْنَ ظَنِّي بِاللَّهِ مِنْ حُسْنِ عِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ, that verily thinking well about Allah Jalla wa Ala is part of excellence when worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We remember the hadith of Jibreel alayhi salatu salam when he asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Mal ihsan? What is ihsan? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam responded, An ta'abudu Allah ka'annaka tarah, fa'in lam takun tarah, fa'innahu yarak. To worship Allah Jalla wa Ala as though you see him. And even though you do not see him, know that he subhanahu wa ta'ala, he sees you. And one of the ways for us to attain perfection, as is in the hadith of Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, as mentioned, is to have good thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And having good thoughts, brothers and sisters, about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is not just in times of goodness when we are happy and everything is going fine for us. It means at all times, meaning in times of difficulty, even in times of a calamity where a person maybe is on their dying bed. The famous hadith of Jabir radiallahu an, in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, as Jabir, he narrated, he said, I heard the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaqul qabla wafatihi bi thalathin, that he said this 3 days before he died, la yamutanna ahadukum illa wa huwa yuhsin adh-dhannu billah, subhanallah, that none of you should die except that they should have good thoughts, be optimistic of that what you will face with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This hadith is in Sahih Muslim. Therefore, we are obliged to think positively about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at a time when it is most essential, maybe when we are going to leave this life, that our deeds come to an end. We should think about the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People who are around that person, to remind them about the rahmatullah, about the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to remind them about the good deeds that they used to do in this life, to think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's unlimited mercy and how that Allah Jalla wa Ala loves to forgive and he loves to be merciful to his servants, those who repent to him. When you think about the name Al-Ghaffar, that you remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the one who forgives all sins. When you think of his name At-Tawwab, that when you repent to him, he is the one who accepts the repentance of his servant. When you think about Al-Razzaq Al-Wahhab, the one who gives, the one who sustains and provides. When you call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with these names, be sure and know and be certain that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hears you and that he subhanahu wa ta'ala will answer your supplication. Part of your perfection in your worship is to have this optimism when you call upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We remember when Ibrahim alayhi salatu salam, when he was at a very difficult time, that he reminded us, even when you are sick, وَإِذَا مَرِضْتُ فَهُوَ يَشْفِينَ, that when I became sick, you are the one who cures. SubhanAllah, Ibrahim alayhi salam at this time did not relay the illness, that it came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that you are the one who makes me sick. No, that when I become sick, that he subhanahu wa ta'ala, he is the one who cures. Whenever a person is faced with an extremely difficult situation, when doctors and consultants and people at the top of their profession have said, there is no cure for this illness, that person never loses hope with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No matter what they are facing, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants good for that person. No one will live forever. No one will live on this earth forever. Even the prophets and messengers, alayhim salatu wasalam, they passed away, but they met their Lord in the very best way. So whatever we are facing, we remember, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ وَدُعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ, and your Lord has said, call upon me and I will answer you. Such a powerful verse in the Quran. Something for you to reflect over. أَفَلَيَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ. Say this verse to yourself time and time again. وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ وَدْعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ. And your Lord has said, call upon me and I will answer you. رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. Upon everything which the universe depends on, nothing exists. Nothing is living except by the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You remember the verse, وَإِذَا سَأَلَكَ عِبَادِي عَنِّي فَإِنِّي قَرِيبُ أُجِيبُ دَعْوَةَ الدَّاعِي إِذَا دَعَانِ. And when my slave asks you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, concerning me, then tell them, I am indeed near. I respond to the invocations of the supplicant when they call upon me. Subhanallah. This is the benefit of having good thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And what a tremendous blessing it is that when you call upon Allah jalla wa ala, that you remember the hadith in Qudsi, in which the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that Allah jalla wa ala said, and this is in the meaning, I am as my servant thinks of me. أَنَا عِنْدَ ظَنَّ عَبْدِي بِي. That I am as my servant thinks of me, so let him think good of me. Subhanallah. This hadith in Qudsi, it continues when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I am as my servant thinks of me, and I am with him when he remembers me. If he remembers me to himself or herself, I remember him to myself. And if they remember me in a gathering, I remember them in a gathering better than that. And if they draw near to me a handspan, I draw near to them an arm's length. And if they draw near to me an arm's length, I draw near to them a fathom's length. And if they come to me walking, I come to them at speed. This hadith is in Al-Bukhari and Muslim. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminds us, whatever goodness and good thoughts we have and optimism we have towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah jalla wa ala will give us back even more. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has more than we can ever imagine. So whenever we think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we think positive thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Al-Hasan al-Basri rahimahullah ta'ala, the famous scholar from the Tabi'een, he said, verily the believer thinks positively of his Lord, therefore he does righteous deeds. And the evildoer who thinks negatively of his Lord, therefore they do evil deeds. Al-Hasan al-Basri rahimahullah ta'ala equated good thoughts and optimism to that person then doing good deeds, and equating negative thoughts and pessimism towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that they would go down a path of evil. Now, this highlights the difference between a person thinking positively about Allah jalla wa ala and a person who is thinking negatively and being deceived. How important it is for us to have this fa'al, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us about, and that is to be optimistic. I want to mention, inshallah ta'ala, finally, with a statement of one of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and then about the dangers of having these negative thoughts and the type of people who have this. Ibn Abi Dunya rahimahullah, he said that Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, he said, فَوَاللَّهِ الَّذِي لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُ. I swear by the one who is not worthy of worship except him, that a believing slave has not been given anything better than having good assumptions and good thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What an amazing and powerful statement of Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu. Now those who think negatively and have bad thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from the munafiqoon, from the hypocrites and the mushrikoon, and those who have disbelieved in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what did Allah jalla wa ala say about these individuals? When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes these types of people who have bad thoughts, when Allah jalla wa ala says, وَيُعَذِّبَ الْمُنَافِقِينَ وَالْمُنَافِقَاتِ وَالْمُشْرِكِينَ وَالْمُشْرِكَاتِ الظَّانِّينَ بِاللَّهِ ظَنَّ السَّوْءِ عَلَيْهِمْ دَائِرَةُ السَّوءِ. And that He subhanahu wa ta'ala will punish the munafiqeen, the hypocrites, and the mushrikun, the men and women from both, who have evil thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Upon them is a disgraceful torment. This is the natija, or the ending, for those who have bad thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that, what can it lead to? Some of the ulama, they said that there is no punishment mentioned in the Quran which is more severe than those who have bad thoughts about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from having such thoughts, And we ask Allah Jalla wa Ala to make us from those servants who have husnul dhan billah, that it directly impacts our lives and that we become better servants to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from the sincere and to allow us be from those accepted Muslims in this life and in the hereafter. Wa sallallahu wa sallam wa barak ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.